Hello, for quite a long time you longed DA8, digital tonalog converter and headphone amplifier were my favorite my reference source. I've paired it with a really nice A28 amplifier made by Yulong too and used them happily. But time don't stand still, so recently Yulong released a new updated model of this combo, DA9. It is very interesting model using AK4497 digital tonalog converter chip featuring powerful balanced headphone amplifier made on JFET discrete balanced amplifiers, and it offers many interesting nice features. Of course, it's not a cheap device, it cost $1,300, but for its features it's a really modest price. I will show it to you now in more details. DA9 came in fairly simple cardboard box. It's made of brown recycled cardboard, nothing super fancy, but everything is packaged nicely and protected via foam inserts really good. Besides the amplifier itself, you will have power cord, normal USB cable and manual. Manual of course printed in both English and Chinese, and the most interesting part here is technical specifications. So it supports DSD over PCM up to DSD over PCM 128, PCM up to 384 kHz, 24 bits overall inputs, and even 32 bits over USB, and native DSD up to DSD 256 over USB and highest resolutions over USB. As you can see, really good signal noise ratio, dynamic range, total harmonic distortions, frequency response, great crosstalk, so everything is perfect. And as you can see, really good headphone amplifier power. So from single end output for 32 ohms load it will give 2 watts, and from balanced output it will give even 3 watts. So it's enough power to drive almost all, even power hungry cans. It is good addition to DA8, that because DA8 sometimes lacked a bit driving power itself and required amplification, but this one is a real beast. I was a bit sad because Yulong moved from their typical design to more modern one. I really liked their previous design version, this stacking device that can be stacked together. And as you can see, DA9 done in style with with their previous pretty inexpensive model ADA1. It offers really stylish golden front panel. Here is the screen. Unfortunately, it's not really bright, so I can't show it to you because it's almost not visible under my bright lights in studio. But I will describe what is present on the screen. 6.3 millimeter headphone out, balanced headphone out, and universal knob. It can be rotated and pressed. All controls are done via this knob. Short press allows you to switch inputs. Longer press allows you to switch output modes. There are 3 output modes: headphone output, preamplifier when you can select volume for the line out, and pure DAC when without volume regulator. Also, you can use it to select filters via even longer press, and the longest press allows you to select one of 3 sound modes, because Yulong put here 3 different sound modes which alters frequency curve. Sound mode 1, it is linear. Sound mode 2, it's with V-shaped signature with accent on lows and highs. And sound mode 3 is mid-centric. So you can select what you can what you want. Combined with the possibility to select digital filters of the DAC itself, it gives you pretty lot of different sound combinations. Of course, they don't change general representation much, but adds different flavors to this sound, so you can select the one you want. So I will open picture in the manual to show you what is shown on the screen, probably. Let me open this necessary page. Not this one. Here it is. So, output selected, PCM, or DSD, or DSD over PCM, sound mode, if it's available only for PCM signal, sampling rate, volume, sharp, and the output mode. So as you can see, screen represents, screen shows everything related to this amplifier. Nice fits, very big, strong chassis, it's pretty heavy, actually, so it stands very reliably on the table. But as you can see, it's pretty small. Unfortunately, it doesn't fit completely to the frame, but it's not big, so it will, you will easily find a place on your desktop or everywhere. And on the back panel, it is power socket, fuse, on-off switch, power voltage selector, USB in, IS EBU, optical and coaxial in, and balanced and single-ended line out. So as you can see, you will have all the connectivity options that you'd like. So DA9 is absolutely universal device, as well as DA8, and it became even more universal. I can highlight that now they're using separate chip for volume control, and it is better than volume regulation via the DAC chip as it done in previous versions. So this version will work better as preamplifier, for example, with some high-end power amplifier. And of course, about the sound. DA9, it is a step to another direction compared with DA8. DA8 was really good amplifier and headphone amplifier and digital tonal converter, but its sound were a bit darkened. Actually not big, but it has some added energy on the lower frequencies, while DA9 is closer to neutrality, but it offers still really great sound. Lower frequencies are fast, energetic, with good slam, with good punch, impact, with good texture, great resolution, and so on. Actually, really good lower frequencies because of very powerful amplifier. Bass here really shines. It really represents nicely for this price tier. Of course, much more expensive solutions will be better, but for $1,300, it is really, really good option. So, bass transitions greatly to mid frequencies, which are also good, but they are not super resolving, they are not natural, they are natural, but not super resolving, not dry and not clinical. It's on natural side, it doesn't add any emotions, but it doesn't sound too dry, and it doesn't go into nitpicking, showing all the tiny nuances of sound, and like some analytical amplifiers and some analytical combos does. So it's a great balance between musical representation and actually the level of detailization. Many people call this typical AK sound, but I don't like this theory about specific sound of digital tonal converter chips, because more sound is more defined by the amplifier, not by digital tonal converter itself. So it's not correct to estimate the device by the chip it's used, because single chip can be prepared in different ways and show really different sounding. Sometimes this digital tonal converter and headphone amplifier combo reminds me a little bit Aston and Kern players, high-end one, because here is present this small traces of this liquid mid frequencies, with which sounds a bit smoother, but with good note separations and good attacks and decays. Vocals sound like a charm here, especially if you select certain mode which highlights mid frequencies, but without that it also sounds nicely. It has good, really good sound staging, almost widest that I've got from all devices, a bit worse in depth, but still very good, with good layer separation, with good instrument separation, lot of air, really really wide and deep staging. Trebles also pretty nicely. It's a bit not smooth, but it's not aggressive. It doesn't have sharpest attacks, but really it has treble here has really good decays, but not sharpest attacks, and it gives this sense of general smoothness. Sometimes, of course, it's a bit because of this smooth attacks, it's lacking some tiny details, but it's lacking some aggression on treble. In the recordings, it has a lot of cymbals, a lot of brass in recording, but it's not much, and it's not a big issue. It's just this characteristic of this device. It's not aggressive on treble, and many people will definitely like it. It's great for almost all styles of music. You can find the combinations that will suit you nicely using different sound tuning modes. It pairs well with almost all headphones that I have, even with sensitive IEMs. It sounds pretty nicely because of good volume regulation implementation. And with the toughest planar headphones, it's also really good because it has enough driving power. So it is a very nice, very universal combo. Unfortunately, Long didn't put here wireless connectivity like in ADA1, but I think it's not possible for high-end device to implement Wi-Fi nicely, because Wi-Fi will interfere with its schematics, giving some noise and so on. So anyway, it is really good universal device with lot of inputs, lot of outputs, lot of connectivity options, lot of sound tuning options, lot of driving power. It's nicely designed, it's small, compact, fairly priced, so I definitely can highly recommend it to you. Thank you for attention.